I'm Tom Gooding. I'm the president of the Valdosta Rotary Club, and I'm a former chairman of the board of our Chamber of Commerce. On behalf of the members of the Valdosta Rotary Club, we're delighted to welcome all of you. There's over 430 people for this event. I don't think there's an empty chair in the room. This is the 10th annual federal legislative lunch that the Chamber has sponsored. Today, our theme is partnering together. This is the fifth year that Valdosta's two Rotary Clubs have put on this event with the Chamber, and it's the second year that the Valdosta Board of Realtors and the South Georgia Home Builders Association have also joined in to put this wonderful event together. And again, we appreciate each of you being here. I'd like to ask all the members of the Valdosta Rotary Club to stand so we can give you a round of applause and appreciation of all that you do. Please stand. To tell you just briefly about some of the service projects that the Valdosta Rotary Club sponsors each year, among them are the Law Enforcement Appreciation Dinner that I know many of you attend in this room. That organization collects money to provide emergency support for our law enforcement officers when, God forbid, they're injured or their house burns down or some true emergency. We try to be there with the financial aid to help them along in the short term. We also sponsor the Imagination Library, and this year two special focuses of our club are the Young Entrepreneurs Academy, which we are partnering with the Chamber on, and also Saving Lives with Medicine, which is an initiative with the South Georgia Partnership for Health. If you're not a Rotarian, come and join us and find out what it's all about. I'd also at this time like to thank our media sponsors who are giving their services gratis to help with this event. EventPoint, Motion Wave, and Velis, let's give them a round of applause and appreciation. My friend Clarence Spires, who is the president of the North Valdosta Rotary Club. Thank you.
Greetings. On behalf of the members of the Valdosta Rotary Club, welcome to this meeting. At this time, could I ask the members of the Valdosta Rotary Club to please stand and be recognized? Thank you. Partnerships. Let me mention what I think the value and the benefits and the power of partnerships to you are by giving you a little bit of information. This meeting today, look around you, this is the result of the partnership formed by the collaboration of the Valdosta Lounge Chamber of Commerce, the Valdosta Board of Realtors, the Home Builders Association of South Georgia, the Valdosta Rotary Club, the Valdosta North Rotary Club, and the Nashville Berry Rotary Club. And indeed, the Valdosta North Rotary Club's annual signature fundraiser is a partnership with the local businesses, merchants, and individuals, and of course this year, the Valdosta Tech University. This event is called the Teacher Appreciation Dinner, and it raises thousands of dollars each year to benefit the teachers from all 22 Lounge Valdosta schools. The teachers that are chosen as the teachers of the year. Indeed, we have other partnerships with the Valdosta North Rotary Club and our merchants to provide benefits to the local advocates and supporters. We also have other partnerships with the Salvation Army at Christmas time, with the Habitat for Humanity at spring for building houses for the needy. And not the least of the partnerships that we have is with the 1.2 million Rotarians worldwide. And as a lot of you know, in Atlanta this year, this organization raised $450 million as a result of the partnership with the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. Now today we have some special guests. I would like to ask the leadership at Moody Air Force Base to stand when I call your name. And audience, please hold your applause until all have been interviewed. Colonel Jennifer Short, 23rd Wing Commander at Moody Air Force Base. Colonel Susan Reardon Smith, 23rd Support Group Commander at Moody Air Force Base. Colonel Jeff Valencia, 93rd Wing Commander at Moody Air Force Base. We also have a number of other veterans with us today from Veterans First Light. Would you stand and be recognized? My pleasure to introduce to you Joe Herndon, the president of the Home Builders Association of South Georgia.
Thank you. On behalf of the Home Builders Association of South Georgia, I'd just like to say again thank you for inviting us. We love this event. We've done it for 2 years, and we want to continue this type of event, and just look forward to it next year also. Our Home Builders Association charter was started in 1965, and currently we have 175 members, with our primary function being to ensure that our members stay in business and are able to provide quality and affordable housing, that the industry regulations are for the betterment of the industry as a whole and do not add cost that are make the house cost too much. One of the biggest ways that we keep housing affordable and attainable to all is to advocate on our members' behalf. And this is the type of event and partnership being key to that, allowing us to maintain relationships with our representatives who help regulate the housing industry. It's time, if you're a member of the Home Builders Association of South Georgia, would you please stand so we can recognize you? I'm here to give the invocation, and I've been asked I'm going to say a prayer and then to play the lead and national anthem. But if everybody would go ahead and stand now, so we can do it. All right, guys, please. Dear God, we thank you and praise you for your presence here today. I thank you for all the organizations that have helped to put this program on today, and I ask that you stay part of these great organizations in their future. I'd also like to say a special prayer for all those affected by Hurricane Harvey. Please be with them and help them feel the peace that you offer. Please be with all those that will be helping in the recovery process also. So bless the food that we've had to nourishment of our body and us your service. In your name, amen. At this time, I'll introduce Rich Joyner.
My name is Reg Joyner. I'm the current president of the Valdosta Board of Realtors. And since everyone is standing already, there's really no need for me to ask all the members of the Board of Realtors present here today to stand. How about if you raise your hand? And we'll do it that way. And there's a group there. I am excited excited about the partnership. This is our second year participating in this, and I know Myrna has told me that there is about 430 of us here today, but I'm going to say, and Myrna hinted at this, by preacher's count, we've got about 675 at least. And so that should go in the newspaper, right? Okay. Let me just real briefly, so I won't have you standing too long, mention some of the charitable causes that the Board of Realtors has been involved with so far this year. We started off the year working, if you remember, with the victims of the tornado that hit the Adel area. We worked with those victims. We worked with the Cancer Partnership Fund. We worked with the Haven. We worked with the LAMP so far this year. That's the Lounge Associated Ministries to People. We also did a small part working with Back the Blue, which was already mentioned, sponsored by the Rotary Club. And we are currently in conjunction with the Realtor Relief Foundation working to assist the victims of the flood taking place now in Texas and particularly the Houston area. As far as advocacy is concerned, we are also very supportive here locally of the Realtors Political Action Committee, who sponsors and supports local, state, and federal candidates to concentrate on private property ownership rights. And we hold that very dear to our heart. And it would be remiss for me not to mention probably our most famous member of the Board of Realtors here today. And correct me if I'm wrong, Senator, but I believe you were first licensed in 1967, when the earth was still young, he says back then. So he's been with us a while, and we're proud to have him as a member of the Board of Realtors. Is concerned among the groups, to me it's really quite simple. Just look at the people around you. Look at the political influence in this room. And when you combine that political influence of the Rotary Clubs, the Home Builders Association, the Board of Realtors, and the Chamber of Commerce, honestly, when we set our mind to do something, who can get in our way? Who can stop us? To me, that is what partnership is all about. I would now like to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance, please. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. I would now like to introduce to lead all of us as we join together and sing our national anthem, Ron Hatchett with First Baptist Church, and he will be accompanied by Mrs. Barbara Milhouse. Thank you, I could not find that on my page. Barbara Milhouse. So let's all join together in our national anthem.
Still there, oh, say does that star-spangled Commerce, Government Affairs.
Thank you, Reg. It's so good to see all of you here today, and thank you for taking time out of your busy schedules to come be a part of this. This is our 10th Federal Legislative Luncheon, and we appreciate the sponsors who have helped put this together. If you look on the front of your bulletin, you will see them. But we want to recognize our Rotary Clubs. That's the Valdosta Rotary Club, the Valdosta North, and the Nashville Rotary Clubs in helping us sponsor this, along with the Home Builders of South Georgia, the Valdosta Board of Realtors, and the Valdosta Lowndes County Chamber of Commerce. So let's give all of these people who worked hard a round of applause, please. And I appreciate all of you who have come from your various lines of business and profession to be a part of this and help South Georgia be heard. And we appreciate each one of you who've had a part of this, and especially those of you here on the program today. Thank you very much. Now, I would be remiss, and she doesn't want me to do this, but we all know in the Chamber of Commerce and in this community that there is a person who has not been seen on this platform today, but who has done probably more work than all of us put together, and that is the president of our Chamber of Commerce, Ms. Myrna Ballard. And Myrna, thank you so much for all that you've done. Now she will give me an evil eye after it's over with, but those of us know that Myrna's one of those guys that doesn't want to jump in front of the camera and do all the talking, but she will do all the work and then let you take the credit. So Myrna, thank you for all of your leadership here in our community. We're going to have a special presentation for a moment, and I'm going to ask you to draw your attention to the screens on either side of the room.
Johnny Isaacson is our